Hello, everybody. My name is Sinvicta, and welcome to your first impressions of Abandoned Ship. This is an FTL pirate mishmash roguelike that TB introduced me to yesterday, at the time of this recording anyway, on the co-optional podcast, and it looks like it's going to be right up my alley. It did release in early access on the 21st of February, brought to you by Fireblade Software. This key was not provided to me. I simply just bought it, and from everything that it sounds from TB, I saw Jesse was playing it a little bit earlier today, but I didn't actually watch him because I wanted to experience it for myself. Plus, I've been looking for an excuse to actually do a brand new first impressions here and sort of revitalize the series. It's not really my own WTF is version, it's just me simply giving you my literal first impressions of when I install the game. I don't go through the settings or anything unless there's something important, and just let you know how it is. So usually these videos tend to be on the shorter side. And by the way, this was live recorded on Twitch. Plus, something else I should mention really quickly is that for some odd reason, I don't know why this trend happened, but if you click out of the window while the game is running, it actually mutes itself. So I really wish that game developers would not do that, or at least give me the option to. And yeah, the music at the main menu is super loud sometimes, which is a little bit silly. But here we go. Again, I know absolutely nothing about the story. I know absolutely nothing about the game. Never played before. We are just going to dive right on in and take a look at your first impressions for Abandoned Ship, brought to you by Fireblade Software. Here we go. Start new. New game name. First impressions. Tutorial's on. Yes. Difficulty. I don't really know why I would change it off of normal. Player generated names. By Simon Banus. If you take the box of new player generated names from the newsletter. By signing up to the Abandoned Ship newsletter, you can have your name added to the game. If you tick the box, then all player generated names from the newsletter will be spawned into the game. Yeah, but I just want to name people. I'll leave that check for now because I don't know what that means. So we're gonna find out. Here we go. You can rename your travelers. So, all right. Greetings, hero. Welcome to Abandoned Ship. Hello, Uncle Deckard. A wild chorus. The birth of a monster, which appears to be a Kraken hero. You could also misconstrue it as the number 8. Okay. That moment, the final strand is cut. A burst of clarity, of your recent existence draws upon you. Escape is all that you can think of. You have to get away from Diablo. Leia. The tentacles flail wildly in the water. People drop to their knees, hero. Some through fear, others with adulation. Their god is a manifest. Watch from your position of privilege on a private balcony. Notice your two bodyguards, finger air quotes, are distracted and enraptured. Strike them down and flee this accursed place. Yeah. By the way, I should also mention that there's a lot of very Lovecraftian Cthulhu-style Eldritch stuff going on right now. I should have probably mentioned that at the very beginning. Alright, instinctively grabbing something, you smash it down on the head of the first guard. Shock and surprise registers on the second before you two is down. You are unsure whether they are dead or unconscious. You feel a drip from your fingers. You look down at your improvised weapon, a small idol of father. Father capitalized. It's cracked and has cut your hand. You are drifting, but something inside you snaps back to reality. Look, there goes gravity. Look, there. I forget the rest of the lyrics. You have to move fast. The cells offer the safest route to freedom. I guess we flee. You stride into the prison with feigned authority. No matter. This place is unguarded in our, now their, moment of triumph. Escaping alone would be futile, so you grab the keys from the guard room and approach the prisoners. Who will you unlock first? Okay, so we've got Barrett, Seafort, M. Forasetto, Colton, and Ruben. And they all have varying stats. Let's see. Navigation. The higher navigation skill is the faster the maneuvre bar is recharged. Not maneuver, maneuvre. Current experience of the skill 100, next 200. That's navigation, reload. Reload weapons at an improved rate. Repair. Okay, that's the speed of repair, and this is melee combat, I assume. So we should probably get someone who is, like, pretty good at repairing, because I think we're going to need it. So I'll unlock Ruben. The sailor repairs the ship at a faster rate. Unlock him. Who's this? Severed one. I think that might be me. Unlock. Hello, Ruben. Who will I release next? Let's get the navigator. Yeah. Noise must have raised suspicion by now. Hurry and bestow freedom to one more prisoner. What is this? Oh, it's a surgeon. Yeah, definitely want the surgeon. Colton. There we go. You and your new companion surge through the labyrinth passages. Finally, a door. Light seeps through cracks in the frame. Burst through the door. Close your eyes for a moment as the sea breeze brushes your face. Looking down at the winding path ahead, you'd see what you hoped for, a ship at anchor. It was likely stolen and repurposed by the cult. Time to put it to better use. All right, so here is the main screen of the game, I think. We've got, I'm the captain. See, I'm the captain. Ruben is our sailor. I think that you can rename them, though. Select crew. Selecting crew member by left-clicking on them, and they will have an orange outline. All right, I've done that. Move right click. Oh, okay. So it's RTS style. Okay. Board the ship. Now move all the crew to the ship. So you can just box. It's pretty nice. I like that. Cut the ropes. Cut the ropes that are attached to the crew member. Right click where the ropes attach to the ship. Oh man, this is gonna be micro intensive. Okay. I do believe there is pausing in the game as well. Man the ship's wheels. Now man the ship's wheel and make your escape. Select a crew member and right click on the ship's wheel. Well, we want our navigator to do that. Who was Barrett? Yeah. And we're off at lightning speed. Dozens of furious cultists charge the jetty as you pull away. I won't get you, you kids. Stay off my lawn! Sorry, Force. A high priest at their head. His scream reaches your ears and drips with scorn. Heed me, betrayer! Our father knows and sees you. Always! Like Asmodan in the Black Soulstone. That's not right, Uncle Deckard. You'll never escape his embrace, hero! As he speaks, the other occultists disperse, no doubt, to begin the pursuit on their own vessels. They'll be sending ships after us. Let's get out of here. The coastal fortifications open fire. The ship leaves the jetty. Mortar shells incoming. Uh-oh. Whoa! Mortar shells reduce crew members' health to zero. When this happens, you have a short time to stabilize them. When a crew member is stabilized, they will remain unconscious through the battle, but will survive. If you do not stabilize them in time, they will die. But don't worry. In this one instance, we will freeze the bar right before it runs out. Okay, so we need to get, I can apparently pause with spacebar. So let's get the surgeon over there. I don't need you to repair the steering wheel. I need you to save, like, the captain or the navigator who's bleeding out in front of you, Doc. Thank you. The barrage has damaged the ship hull, and the bottom left screen shows the bar that is the hull health. If this bar is empty, then the ship will sink. Okay, so that is our HP down at the bottom left. The ship is divided into sections. In the bottom right, the sections and their individual health are displayed. Section health influences the performance of everything in that section. Yellow health means it's 50% effective. Red health means it won't function at all. Okay, so repairing the ship. We need to repair the mast. People, repair the mast. All right, the navigator is currently stable. We need people to fix the cannons as well. I will fix the, what is this? The barrage also injured the crew. Crew health can be seen around the, you can heal the crew by sending them to the sick medical bay table. Ah, okay, so that's a medical bay. That's a med bay. Well, then I will take that. We'll send the doc over there, and I'll take over as captain. There we go. And yeah, by the way, I was taking the navigator there, not the doc. It's not over yet. Take cover. That's a whoa. Okay. All right. Uh-oh. We've been hit by a weapon that causes hull cracks. These splinter the deck and make the ship take on water. There's a water gauge above the hull health. If this reaches the top, the ship will also sink. Oh, man. Listen out for the ship bell. This will warn you when water gauge has reached critical levels. The bell will also sound when your hull health is dangerously low. Act decisively when you hear the bell or you may sink. Okay, so we need to get the... Let's see. Navigator, you go there. I'll help out with this one first. Oh, that was easy. Emptying the water gauge. You can lower the water level by manning the pumps at the back of the ship. Oh, that's what those are. Okay, select a crew member, right-click on the water pump to man it. Okay. I wonder if they're... Oh my god, they're hotkeyed. Oh, that is beautiful. Thank you, game. They are actually hotkeyed. That is awesome. As an old-school RTS player, this is... That's wonderful. We're nearly out of range. One more barrage incoming. Dance around like your life depends on it, boys. Oh. We have fire. What do we do about fire, game? When struck by a weapon with flaming ammunition, the fire is broken out. Fire's damage sections and enters the crew. They will spread unless your crew extinguishes them. Very much like FTL. Select a crew member and hover the mouse over the curse. Right-clicking. Okay. Yeah, it's just... Yeah, got it. I'll take this one. You two get this one. By you two, I mean just you, apparently. There we go. We're out of range, but stay alert, men. Flee! You can leave combat. Neat. Send in the Rockmen. Let's see. Escape. Escape cat. Okay. Exploration mode. This is exploration mode. You can move your ship by clicking around the area. If you prefer, you can hold down the mouse cursor or the mouse button and the ship will move. Okay, that's neat. Do that. Whoa, man. Okay, we were... Oh, man, that's beautiful art. I love that. It reminds me of, like, an old-school, like, Civ game. Oh, you can actually left or right-click. Okay. View map. You can see the whole map by clicking the highlighted map button. Okay, so these are little channels that allow you to leave the area that go to different parts, like different maps and stuff. And that's what TB was showing yesterday on the co-optional podcast. This is the map of the immediate area. If you wish to travel to a new area, you must move through the gate that's been highlighted at the bottom of the screen. The other gates cannot be opened quite yet. Okay, so this is literally gating where you can and cannot go for now. I understand. Return to the exploration. I don't know if there's a hotkey for that. Doesn't matter. Here we go. Explore exploration map gates. Navigate to the other. Use the button. View the whole map. You need to remember where it is. I'm just gonna go south. Game. The gate is locked. Lock gates can be opened by completing a set number of events. Okay. There's an event marker. Left click on it to sail to it, and that will trigger the event. A patrolling cult ship has stumbled upon us. Man the guns. We owe them no mercy. Oh man, this is gonna be great. Remember the lessons you've learned so far. I've already forgotten them. Manning weapons. Man the cannons facing the enemy. One crew member can man an entire battery of cannons. Left click a crew member and right click on the cannons to man them. Okay, so I will take control of firing because, like, that seems to make sense. This is our... We've got our navigator up. Sailor. What was he good at? He was good at repairing. We don't have anyone. I'm the only one with a 2 in reload speed. Don't worry, guys. I've got this. Weapon reloading. Weapons will reload if someone is manning. If someone is manning them, the section health is not in the red. Keep the cannons manned until the reloading bar turns blue. Okay. I guess there's no reason why we shouldn't put 3 of them on there. Maybe. Oh, there's okay. So there's just 2 guns over there. Okay, I got it. Whoa! Aiming the cannons. Now the weapons are loaded. Left click on the weapon to select it. The mouse cursor will turn to a crosshair. You move it over the enemy ship. Right click to confirm the order. Fire 2 barrages at the enemy vessel. Got it. All right. Aha! Game pausing. Pause the game by pressing the space bar. That's what I'm so used to FTL. I'm used to that. Once you dismiss this message, you can issue orders while the game is paused. Make use of this if things are spiraling out of control. Crew specialities. Specialties. remember, each crewman has a specialty. A crewman assigned to the specialist role will confer bonuses. This efficiency will often mean a difference between glory and the briny depths. Hover over the mouse. Yeah, okay. So I knew that. I did that instinctually. Activate pause. You can hover the mouse over any UI object to gain additional information when you've issued order. Okay, so let us... our hull is currently... We need to repair stuff, so you... You repair that. Distance bar. When we want to get close to the enemy ship, the distance bar on the far left shows you how far away they are. Ah, that's what that means. You can see the target distance by clicking the buttons. If I click this... click, okay. Swivel game, swivel guns, chain shot. The enemy wants to keep their distance, so they're moving away from you. In the top right of the screen is the enemy section health. Oh, I see it. Okay. That's what this is up here. I was wondering where I could see them. This is where they're, okay. So this is their HB. This is their water gauge. And then these are their components. Their rooms, if you want to call that from FTL. In the top right, we can catch them, we manage to damage the mast section. Man the chain shot swivel, get the gun fully loaded. Yeah, I'm on it. Okay, so you can actually queue up, it looks like, where you can fire, basically, just by... You can pre-queue that? That's pretty neat. Swivel gun is loaded and ready. Aiming the chain can the chain shot. The chain shot can be only aimed at the sails, but deals high damage to them. When this is ready to fire, left-click the weapon, right sails. When it turns white, right-click to fire. When the crosshair turns white, right-click to fire. Keep the firing chain until the enemy mass is damaged to red. Okay. So let's fire on their sails. Oh man, that is awesome. Keep steering. We probably don't need someone navigating right now. These guys will just auto fire, okay. Their masts are down, I think. Hey, repair that. I don't know if I can... I don't know if I'm supposed to be controlling right now, or if we've got the, I don't know if we have the... What's this? Repair this section. Being repaired. Oh, you know why? It's because we don't have anyone on the steering wheel. That's right. There we go. Okay, yeah. So that was my fault. So I took the navigator off of the steering wheel. That's the reason why we weren't going anywhere. Let's see. Grape shot. Damaging their mast section in the red made it easier to catch up. Now you're at close distance with other swivel gun and will be in range. This one is a grape shot. It's anti-personnel weapon. Nothing personnel. Man it and get it fully loaded. Can do. Oh, they repaired their masts. Oh, no they didn't. No they haven't. Alright. Grape shot's ready. Aiming the grape shot. Like, a template will appear. Place it over as many crew members as possible when you're... Oh, okay. So I queue up the top. Yeah, okay. It's AOE then. Ooh. Charging the maneuver bar. Let's ram the enemy. You can perform special maneuvers like this when the maneuver bar is full. The maneuver bar is charged when someone is manning the helm. Someone with a high navigation will fill up the bar faster. Okay. You can perform maneuvers like this. Do we not have... Hey! Oh, there we go. Ramming. Now that the bar is fully charged, maneuvers are available. When you're ready, press the highlighted button. Maneuvers can only be initiated if someone is manning the ship's wheel. Got it. Let's ram them. Brace for impact. One moment. Certain actions like this cause a brace for impact test. Failing the test means crew will fall to the deck, temporarily interrupting what they're doing. When a brace occurs, the highlighted button will become active.
Welcome to the
press
mosh
it in time,
pit.
Otherwise you will fail the test. As this is your first time, we'll let you press the button now. Got it. We're bracing. Boom! That guy's in the air. The enemy failed the brace test. The impact has even caused one of the crew to be knocked overboard. They can man the winch in back of the ship to save them. If they don't make it, they will drown. Your own winch is highlighted. If any of your crew fall in the water, just be sure to man. Okay, so that's the winch. That's what the winch is for then. Now I'm sure we're gonna learn boarding then. Oops. Oh, apparently I'm boarding. Hey, we need you over here. We got their navigator. Reuben, get out of there. Don't worry, we got you. I think we did it. Victory! At the end of the battle, you're able to salvage anything of value. This tutorial combat enemy did not react aggressively as it normally would, so be prepared for a tougher fight next time. Grab what you can and be quick about it. More ships will be on their way. 20 gold. You don't need to worry about repairing your sections or healing your crew. This happens automatically when you go back to the exploration map. As long as you have water pumps going in the back, they will automatically empty your water gauge too. Okay. So we've taken on a little bit of water, but let's go ahead and man that. Return the exclamation. Let's just get the exploration, I should say. We have someone on the are you manning the pumps? I'm assuming, or no, that's a winch. Where's the pump? There we go. All right, I got it. I understand. So I think we'll do one event here and then wrap it up, because this video is already getting a little bit longer. Now the gate's open, we can flee the space. Let's click the water bridge to return to the map. World map, this will show you travel between maps has a supply cost. Left click on another map, like destination. Got it. Very nifty. Quest, you announce to the crew you need to take stock and they're not to be disturbed. In the captain's cabin, you find some clean clothes, likely to belong to the poor previous occupant before the cult had their way with the ship. Feels good to finally be out of your flowing ceremonial robes. You store them neatly. Damn yourself in the mirror. Ah, okay. So this is the Sinvicta. This is the character creator. I like it. Sure. Your Severed One devoted fathers. You can edit the name of your crew in the management menu. Okay. You didn't even recognize you. The face looking back at you. Who are? Were you? All you're certain of is that your past was stolen away by a being you know as Father. Spark within you, pierce the fog of your blind devotion. You must kindle it if you have any chance of remaking yourself. Then the hunt for the answers and revenge can begin. You reemerge on the deck. The crew snap to attention. We may have escaped, but we're not safe yet. We must make port and then go our separate ways. It's me thereafter. You return to the cabin and slump into the chair. Moments later, a strong undercurrent of exhaustion pulls you into a deep sleep. Still loved, always in his thoughts, you were the first. But he knew something within you has changed. Thus, you were marginalized, became a symbolic icon with no real power. You didn't care. Something in you was gaining strength little by little. The fog was clearing. Quest, a sharp knock at the door awakes you. Moments later, you stride back to the deck as you issue commands. The cult fortress is far from inhabited lands. We will need to navigate open waters before we can find a port. Okay. We can see our sheep. This is the lone ship view. It allows you to change your default settings and will be used in combat. Okay. Preferred distance. Press a button on the distance bar to set your preferred range. In combat, this will mean your ship will automatically try to reach that distance. I don't know. Like, there? I'm not sure what the preferred distance will be. Saving crew positions. You can save your crew positions at the start of the range of crew and the optimal and press the save location button. Okay, so yeah. So, I want Sinvicta. I want you manning the guns. Doc, you can man the other guns. Sailor, you can man the grape shot, and we'll say that's Gucci for now. Okay, if you ever need to return your crew to the save location, you can press the highlight button anytime. Got it. Highlight button can also be used to bring the ship about. In battle, this can only be performed if your maneuver bar is fully charged. Here you can set your preferred side, which should be facing the enemy when you start a battle. This can be useful to equip each side with different styles of weapons, such as one with short range, the other with longer range weapons. Ah, okay, I understand that. So we could put like our close combat weapons here and then our long range combat here, and then have everything shift. I like that. Let's continue trying to escape the occult by fleeing from them. The exploration map, locate the exit gate, and complete the required number of events to unlock it. Got it. Escape capture. You're in great danger while being so close to the cult. The reach of the cult extends far. Escape this area and search for port. What is that? I feel like probably cult event spotted. I ain't scared. You're on direct course to come in the range of the approaching cult vessel. Engage them. The cult shan't have us this day. Plot an escape course to step in. No. We're going to engage them. All right, so this is our first real combat. This is where we'll be ending the first impressions video. Let's see how this one goes. We probably don't need the grape shot. We need you to be manning the chain shot. But you can. What I like is you can actually preload stuff as well. That's pretty good. All right, they're already taking on water. They got their sails. Maneuver bar is full. We're not close enough to engage them yet. We got to bring their masts down, and we want to board them. I guess technically we don't have to board them. We do enough damage to their hull, but it seems like boarding, much like in FTL, it seems like boarding will maybe get you more rewards. Look at the hull. I mean, right now we're owning them, so it doesn't seem like the masts. It does not seem like the chain shot actually fires on its own, but the side cannons do. Okay, and this shows you the preferred range as well. Over there, that's what those icons mean, I'm guessing. So we need to get in close to getting range. They're trying to stay away from us right now. They're actually pulling away. Keep firing, team. All right, they're red. We should be able to get in close now. We need to be ready with a grape shot. Keep hitting them. Get in close. Man, they've got a really good repairman over there on their masts. There we go. I think we're gonna destroy him before we can board him. Yep, there they go. Woo! Well, we did take a lot of damage there, but I do like that the ship repairs itself. Hey, with the ship disposed of, you search the wreckage, find barrels of cotton, valuable when sold to the right person. Ooh, that's what that is. Neat. All right, well, I think we're going to end it there. So that is my first impressions of Abandoned Ship. Man, I can already tell that this game is going to be right up my alley, as I initially suspected. And I got to say, I mean, coming over from, an experienced RTS player, the controls are very, very tight. It definitely reminds me a lot of FTL and a lot of the management aspects of it. But first impressions, extremely good. Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. Let me know if you would actually want to see a series maybe here on YouTube. This is a brand new game that, like I said, I just now heard of thanks to TB. So I may do a follow-up video since this one was a little bit more tutorial heavy, obviously, because again, you're seeing my first impressions of it. But again, let me know in the comment section down below. Subscribe, of course, if you want to see more here of Darkest Dungeon, The Binding of Isaac, or even possibly maybe Abandoned Ship. As always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.